Hello, everybody. It's Heather at the Kraaft Shaak. How are you doing? I am very excited for today's show. I had spent some time this morning hanging out with my dear friend Andrew Hatchett, who has inspired me and instructed me on some of the things that part of today's show is going to be brought to you by the mind of Andrew. And I don't know if that's a good thing or not. Anyway, so I wanted to say hi, and I wanted to say hi to Debbie. Debbie, do you want to tell everybody hello?
Hi, everybody. I don't know if you can see me or not. I'm busy working over on the G+ page, but good to see you.
So very cool. We have got a number of folks in the audience, so I want to say hello to everybody as I see them right now, which would be Andrew, Michael, Nanette, Sylvia, Susan, Tina, Sandra, Kathy, Beth, or Lizzie, as I like to call her, Sherry, and Sheila. So thank you all for joining us live. And for those of you joining after this moment or watching on the YouTube page, we encourage you to join us at craftshaak.com/live. That's where it's all happening. And if you would ever want to know how to watch the show after it's over, go up to the top of my webpage up there. It says Video Treasure Chest. Don't go there now. You're watching this show. But after the show is over, you can go to the Video Treasure Chest and watch it there anytime. So just a little bit there. I think that's everything. I wanted to talk to you about Monday meanderings. I did actually do one, two in a row. So yesterday I hung out with T-Dog. We chatted quite a bit. We had some live viewers. Thank you, ladies, for joining us live. And that was really exciting. T-Dog was incredibly thrilled to have actual comments come in over the screen. He was pretty thrilled about that. So that turned out pretty neat. And what else? I covered a lot. I covered a lot in Monday Meandering, so there's like nothing to say. I have nothing to say. Yeah, right. Anyway, so today what we're going to do is head over to the craft table. Do you want to just do that? Should we just do that?
Let's do that. And I want to apologize to everyone. I'm on really slow internet today, so I'm not going to talk a lot in case it's all garbled or something. And we're having some issues. We're not able to bring up comment tracker, so we'll just shout you out as we see some comments here, but we're not able to bring them on screen. But I am going to mark them. So those of you who are right here in the Business Hangouts interface, you'll be able to see which comments we've got marked.
Yeah, and before we start, I want to actually mark this one. I love it. Sherry says, Sherry Whitfield, thank you for joining us. Got my lunch heated up just in time. Hi, everyone. So, you know, it's the lunch hour for some of us, and thanks for rubbing it in, Sherry, that you have lunch and I don't. Anyway, we'll get a move on. Okay, so I just wanted to say that this is going to be a fun one, I hope. What I want to do is talk about paper piecing and Gelli Plate pulls. So first, look at this. Huge stack of Gelli Plates that I have organized a little bit so that they don't look nearly as messy as they normally do. But, I mean, this is a huge stack of pulls. I'm pretty sure Sylvia probably has like three times this many, but I want to be able to use them, and that's been kind of a drawback to this whole Gelli Plating adventure of mine, that I don't know what to do with them after, and some of them, you know, I've made some pretty big boo-boos on in my mind that did not turn out how I wanted it to, but what am I going to do with it? So I came up with an idea for how to use these, and hopefully that's what we'll see today. So the first thing you're going to start with is a pad of paper, and you just want to do a simple line drawing. Now, for this particular one, because I want to be able to use it on a card, which, by the way, I have to show this off. This is a card from the stamp that I carved, and I know a lot of you have already seen this, but I'm really proud of it, so I wanted to show it again. But I'm going to use this to give me a guide of basically the size of an A2 card. So I'm just drawing around it. So I've got a rectangle to work inside of. And then I've pulled up on screen for myself just a visual to go by. So it's actually of a lily, which again I told you was inspired by Andrew. He gave me some suggestions for the show. So I am going to just really quickly kind of sketch out what I see on it actually needs to be bigger here, so we're going to do it like that. And over here, and we don't really worry about these. It kind of seems like I'm making a mess here, but we don't really worry about it too much because we're going to go over it. So basically, go ahead.
It looks like Sylvia has been doing some pulls this morning herself.
Of course, that doesn't surprise me.
She is the Gelli Plate Queen.
Yeah, I was just going to say the exact same words. Of course she is, because Sylvia loves that Gelli Plate. Okay, so that's kind of what I want it to be. Let's see, that's not going right. There we go. All right, and then kind of a trumpet shape for the stem going down, and then we'll have some leaves that curve back this way.
And when you're done, could you kind of hold it up to the camera or zoom in when you're done drawing so we can see?
Yeah, and I can kind of zoom in somewhat so it's not as bad here. Is that better?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, rats. Okay, ignore the oh, rats.
We'll take that out in post.
We'll remove that in post, sure. Okay, so here we go. This is basically my lily. I'm going to add some stamen here in the center. Okay, so that's the bottom line of how you roughly draw out a line drawing. Then you take that same drawing, and a Sharpie marker. I'm going to show you some examples of other ones that I've already done off camera, but take your Sharpie marker and you're going to commit to the lines you want to keep. So we're going to keep this line here, and we're going to keep this line here. And then we're going to choose which one of these we want to keep, and I'm going to go with this one right here. It's really not that hard to draw these because it doesn't have to be perfect. And I know some people out there are going, oh my gosh, that's so simple. But, you know, to be honest with you, it doesn't have to be perfect. You're going to be filling this in with your Gelli Plate pulls. So don't worry about it being, a great drawing or you're a perfect artist or any of that. We don't care about that. If it helps you, get some coloring books with those big white, black lines in them and just use those to start with. Okay, so that is it. That's the line drawing that we're going to use for this particular card-sized one. Now, I would take this over to my copy machine, which I happen to have one in here, but you could go down to any office supply store and make copies. If you do four of these on one page, you can make all your copies and have four images, so it's pretty inexpensive. Or you can do some larger images, and let me show you some of the ones that I've done here. These are all pencil drawings here, so you're not going to see them very well, but really quickly I did a vase with some simple flower shapes. I don't know what this is called, but I was kind of inspired by one of the pictures that was posted in our community, which, by the way, if you haven't been to Crafters Community lately, there's a lot to catch up on. They've been very busy over there, very awesome. My wonderful community, you guys are great. And that's a lovely image, isn't it? Let's try the other side of it. How about that? So this one's a little bit more complex. It's a butterfly sitting on a flower. Again, these were all inspired by images I just saw on Google. I just did like line drawings, line art or something like that. This one I drew by myself, and that's when I decided I need to look at something else. Because this was what I came up with, and I went, yeah, I need to look at some pictures. So then I also made this rose. I've already outlined it with a marker, and then I went over to the copy machine and made some copies. So I have probably, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I made 5 copies because I'm going to be using 4 layers. So I need 1 copy as my base, and then these 4 layers are going to get cut up. So it depends on your image as to how many copies you make. So far, we've not made any kind of a mess, and I'm feeling a little bored with myself. Are there any comments out there, maybe, that would
there
make this
are,
a little bit more exciting?
And you can pull the camera back now.
Yes, ma'am.
And Sherry says, gosh, I wish I could draw. And Sherry, I wanted to tell you, I said that 6 months ago, and I am drawing today. So hang out in the community, and you'll get inspired to do that. I have discovered a talent just from hanging out with these ladies.
I know. You really can. You just have to move your pencil, and voila, you're drawing. So go ahead. What else we got?
Susa's in here. She says, sorry I'm late. Had to feed my husband. So we certainly can understand that.
Yes, always feed the husband so that way you can play. That's my motto. Mm-hmm.
I have one here from Sylvia. She says, where is my show? But I think she was just getting anxious at the top of the hour.
Okay. All right, so what I'm going to do now is pull out some, and please interrupt me with comments because I really want the comments to come out as many as we can. But I want to just pull out some of these. I'm looking at the coloring to see what I want my rows to look like. And some of these, I'm going to use off camera, of course, a lot more of this stuff, but I wanted to give you guys the idea, the gist of what we're doing. That's a really cool poll. Check that out.
Beautiful.
You know, I made this with, this is my mom's stamp. My mom actually carved that stamp.
So, Heather, do you have it set up so that when I talk, the camera moves over to me, or can we stay on you when I talk?
The camera moves over to you when you talk. Do you want me to just put it on me?
Yeah.
Okay, you got it. We're kind of easygoing today, aren't we?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm just trying to pull out some, and I really didn't want to plan this too much in advance. I think I'm really feeling this color more than the blues. But I need some green for the leaves. I like that gold too. That's going to be fun. It's also cool to use different types of papers in this. Like this is deli paper and this is computer paper, printer paper. So the different papers will make a difference as well. One more. I'm just going to pull out one more, I promise, and then I'm done looking. Sure. I lied. I don't like lying to you guys, but I did. I apologize. All right, let's use this one for this one and another one for the leaves. These are going to be my leaves. And I'm going to use this one in the center of these. And I'm going to use that one for leaves, too. Okay, so there we go. Okay, so basically what has made me decide this is I really like, see how this, when I lay this one over the top of this one, can you see through it? There's some more layer. And when I put it over the top of this one, that's kind of cool. So by itself, it's very white, but then I put it over top of that. So that's going to be my first roundabout. So here's how I do this. Put it all together and I hold really tight with my thumb and my hand. And I'm just going to cut out the rows and I'm going to leave those leaves off. Now you might not need as many copies as I did, but I didn't want to be without and have to run over there and grab the copies. So I figured, what's the worst thing that can happen? I can have too many copies? I don't think so. So
while you're cutting that, the conversation in the room right now is comparing time zones.
Ooh, cool.
And we have Susa here from the UK and Victor from Ukraine. And then lots of, you know, U.S. time zones as well. So it's very cool that everyone's in the room at the same time.
Oh, I love that. I can't wait to look at that conversation after the show is over. That is awesome. Okay, so here's what I've done. I've cut out the rows. Now, I could really screw things up and look at it to see how it looks. And I could use the rows just like this if I wanted. And think about it. I could actually take this transparent piece and put it over the top of this and outline it in black and be done. Very simple. I could be done right now if I wanted to do that. Then I would lay this transparent piece with the lines on it right over the top of that one, and the rose is complete. That'd be kind of cool. But you know me better than that, so we're going to keep on cutting. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just take a few of these rounds, and I'm adjusting my hand grip because I know that as I cut this off, it's going to fall, and I don't want to lose the connection between the other layers. So this one, there's one paper piece ready to go. And we're going to kind of do, and this was kind of what Andrew came up with, we're going to kind of do like a puzzle piece. And we are going to choose this one right here on the inside.
So we have a couple questions about paper.
Okay.
Sherry said, asked, is deli paper like parchment paper?
Let's see. Yeah, kind of, with a waxy side. Sometimes they're both waxy, sometimes they're highly waxy, sometimes they are dry wax. The box that I purchased, I'll grab it and I'll show it to you. Let me set that down. And I know that there's several people out there who have used different things, but I have standard weight, interfolded, dry wax deli paper. And these are in 8 by 10 and 3/4 inches sheets. And that's what it means by interfolded. So it just kind of came out as, and the next one pops up out of the box. That's interfolded. And dry wax means it's not, you don't have any of that extra filmy stuff. It's dry. But it is definitely smoother on this side and has tooth on this side.
Okay.
So I don't know if that matters.
And then Beth asked if you can use tracing paper for jelly plating.
I believe you can. I don't think there's a rule really about what you can or can't use. But Sylvia is our resident jelly plate expert, so she should probably be the one to answer those kind of questions. But I'm guessing.
Well, as a matter of fact, Sylvia does say you can use just about any paper on the jelly plate except coated paper like photo paper.
Yeah, that is what I was going to say. My glossy cardstock, no, that doesn't work very well. It leaves a film on your jelly plate and can actually damage it, I understand. So, okay, so I basically have a piece here, and you can tell on my original, let's see if I move this off. You can tell in my original what belongs where, so I'm not going to be too panicked about losing what, but I want to keep these together so that I know where to put it when, right there, so I know where to put it when I'm done, okay? Hopefully you guys can see what I'm, you can see it, like, see it unfolding as I'm doing it. So these pieces, I'm going to actually keep, these are the ones that I want to use with this particular rose. And this I'm going to save for another one. So basically when I'm all done with this, I'll probably have multiple roses of the same color scheme. And you don't have to do this part. You could just cut out the part that you want if you didn't want to. But I thought, two for one, man, I'm going to cut once and have art a bunch.
So more talk about paper. Let's see. Sylvia says that you can also use tissue paper.
Oh, yeah.
But if it gets too wet, it'll pull apart.
Yeah.
And hey,
I was just going to say, that reminds me, I can show you a poll that I did, which was actually a napkin pulled apart. You want to see that?
Yeah.
So I pulled a napkin apart. It was one of those decorative napkins that has like pretty flowers and butterflies on it. And I pulled it apart to utilize it. So here's the napkin backside. It's like a two-ply napkin, you see. Mm-hmm. And I actually folded it in half and then jelly printed on one side of it. It's very delicate. It's kind of cool.
Yeah.
And you can, when I unfold it, you can see it's rather transparent in the sense that once I get this wet, you'll be able to see right through it. You'll see all that image, but you'll see none of the napkin. That would be really cool on a canvas or something. So, okay, I think I wanted this piece to go here. Yeah, I do. Go ahead. There was another part of that conversation that you were going to talk about.
Sylvia just said that parchment is more opaque. I think more opaque than the deli paper.
Yeah.
From Sherry's original question.
Yes, that would be correct. But you could use the both. I mean, whatever is readily handy to you. If you have a Costco, I think they have deli paper, or if you have a restaurant supply store, they have deli paper, because it's what you would wrap your sandwich in at the deli. That's what they typically use it for. But not us.
No, not us.
Okay, so these are my pieces over here, and I'm going to just do one more out of this color, that one, the big one right there. I know this is extremely exciting watching me cut paper, but thank goodness for the great conversation going on out there.
There is a lot, and I know you've run through the names again, but let me just do it again because I like to put everyone's name on air anyway. But we've got Andrew and Michael, Nanette, Sylvia, Susan R., Tina, Sandra Artfully Made, Kathy, Rain, Souza, Beth, Sherry, Victor, and Sheila, and Julie Walters.
Awesome.
So lots of people out here, and yes, there's a lot of conversation.
Welcome, everybody, and I really do thank you for joining us live. And for anybody watching this recorded version, live is where it's happening. If you can make it, give it a try because it's fun, right, guys?
It really is fun. And I don't know, I think you posted a comment in here for the live viewers about After Crafter.
I did. So if anybody is interested in the After Crafter party, I just wanted to let you know that if you are watching this recorded version, we invite folks who join us live, we invite them into kind of a backstage pass sort of experience. So those of you who are watching live, check that comment. It's very much up at the top of the comment stream right now.
Right. Just leave a comment if you want to be, just put in AKP, After Crafter Party, and we'll take care of that.
Okay, I'm having difficulty because I can't keep the what's dangling down from messing up my rose down here. Okay, so what I've done is I've just grabbed that other blue and purple color that I told you I wanted to use in the center. And I changed my mind about where I was going to use it. Shocking. So that's on the back. It's just another deli paper, but it's just one. That's it. And now, using my map, basically, this is my map, I'm going to cut out this big one here. And you do want to stay probably on the outside of the line just because that'll give you more room to define it later on if you want to do so. So there's the big one. And I know you can't tell because it's white on white, but I promise it's coming together. From my point of view, it looks beautiful. let's see. this one, this piece right here, to go inside there. That's what we're going to do next.
And again, these are the pulls that you made in last week's show, is that correct?
They're actually a collection of all the pulls I've been making over the course of the year. So yeah, some are from last week and some are from weeks prior to that.
And in the blog post that you posted for today's show, there's a link to last week's show. So if you want to see how she made the pulls, if you weren't here last week, just go to today's blog. And I'm going to get the name of that for those of you who are watching on YouTube. It's called...
And it's actually in the description already. I've linked the blog post in the description.
Of the YouTube?
I did.
Man, you are on it.
Hey, I've been taught well. You might know this lady named Debbie. She's awesome. She's really good at teaching me how to do stuff. So I've learned.
It's like a well-oiled machine, Heather.
Hey, I try. You know, it was really cool, was being able to go through our checklists and just really... really hammer out a great opening to the show before we ever even really got started, and here we were off to a great start. So that's always awesome. I enjoy working with you, my friend.
What I love about our checklists is that Heather opens her checklist and I open my checklist, and then we gab about this, that, and the other thing the whole time while we're clicking off our checklist.
Nobody believes that. Nobody believes that, because we never talk. We never talk about anything ever. Sorry, I interrupted you. Go ahead.
That's okay. I was just talking.
Oh, I love it. So I'm just cutting little pieces. I know this is, I'm telling you, this in my mind was so exciting, and at the moment, not so much, but hopefully, whoops, this goes down one. Oom-ba-da-doom.
The anticipation is building. People are really, they can't wait for the unveiling.
Okay, so now you see this is the parts of the rows that are left. I'm just going to set them all aside over here, and we're going to do one more, and then I promise we'll move on to the leaves. So let me grab another photocopy, and I'm just going to go straight to the middle of this one. Let me make sure. I'm holding this up to the light so that I can see it. And nope, that's not going to work the way I wanted it. Basically, what I'm doing is I see that this particular thing was one of those... what do you call these things? This is the clean-off one. So I was cleaning my brayer. Yeah, and then I had to clean my fingers. As you can see, those are finger swipes. And it's in the middle of the page, as opposed to the way a normal Gelli Plate pull is all over the page. So I want to make sure that most of this goes to the middle part of this rose. So I'm holding it up to the light so that I can see through it and see that, yep, that's how I want it to go. Just wanted to make sure I explained that properly. And for the sake of time, this is what I'm going to do. Because it's driving me nuts to actually make you all watch me cut anymore. I can't handle it anymore. So go ahead.
Patty just joined us. Rose Treasures.
All right. AKA Welcome, Patty. So glad to have you guys. This is wonderful. You know, I got to tell you, too, everybody, that when you sign in early, those of you who do, and then leave a comment, I get those emails. They're like little bursts of joy that show up in the middle of my week as I'm getting ready for the show and doing little things to, you know, in the craft room. I'm in here doing something, and I'll get a little bling, and it tells me that I've got an email, and I go and see, and it's somebody who's just showed up in the craft room, just wanted to check things out, or so excited. I'm here an hour early, like Sherry was this morning. That just thrills me. You have no idea what that does. It makes a very big smile on my face.
And how early can people get in just to, you know, stop by and say hi? I mean, can you get in days early?
As a matter of fact, you could go in right now to next week's show and say hi, but then you'd leave us, so don't do that.
But you could.
Actually, I bet you could go and do that in another window if you're on your computer, and it wouldn't affect the one that you're in.
That's
I bet Michael is saying that right now. All right, so, but yeah, you could go in as soon as I set it up, actually. So there is the center part. And it looks like I missed one tiny spot here, so I'm going to cut one of those out of the orange papers. And I'm wondering if my phone just buzzed because somebody went over and left a comment right now in next week's show. Isn't that funny? It's like, that's happening right now, people, right now. This is live, not a recording. Okay, I'm missing one great big one. I'm going to make that one blue. This is kind of the cool part about it being a puzzle piece is I can see exactly what I need to fill in. You can't because it's all the same color, but trust me, okay? Just take my word for it. I'm a professional. Thank you for laughing because that's really sad.
I don't know why that made me laugh.
No, thank you for laughing. It was supposed to be. Sometimes the jokes are like, lame, lame. Thank God I'm not paying for this, right, people? Okay. All right, so now I've got all these leaves, so I don't need, see, I have the leaves left over because I've carefully cut those, so I can use that for the pieces that I wanted to cut out of leaves. And I really liked, I'm going to do three different leaves because I've got three different papers I chose. And let's go, I'm going to do this right out of the middle. This is so against anything I know in my heart is to not waste stuff, but trust me when I say I've got an idea for how I'm going to end the rest of these parts. Even though it looks like I'm just creating a bunch of mess, I've got an idea for the parts that are left over. And hopefully I'll get to it because I'm looking and seeing we're at the halfway mark. Can you believe it's been half an hour?
I know, a half hour of fussy cutting.
Yeah, not so exciting. This one, I think this is not a very good video to for everybody to be reviewing my abilities, I don't think. But hopefully it'll be fun when it's all done.
I just wanted to say fussy cutting. I like that word.
I know, you do. I've heard you say that before, that you like that word. And I heard the bling that there's comments out there. But I haven't heard that very much, so maybe people are just so enamored by my ability to cut paper.
Oh, you're fussy cutting. I'm spinning through them right here to see who is going to be joining afterwards, all your live viewers. So I'm going through it. But I see a message that was way up at the top that we didn't get to bring up on the screen because our comment tracker isn't working today. So, but I just wanted to put today's message. Above all, love each other deeply. 1 Peter 4:8. I like that one, Heather.
Thank you very much for adding that in there because I like that one too, and I'm very appreciative of what I've been given, and that's this community and the folks who have been involved and everything, and so I want to make sure that all the glory goes to the one who gave it to me. So thank you very much for mentioning that one. All right, let's see. I think this is my final cut. I'm kind of doing this off screen only because I don't want to mess up the rows. That's the only reason why.
Okay, I want to do a little tech talk here. Andrew, who is always watching from behind the scenes, he says, if having trouble with Drive, Hangout Toolbox, lower thirds, etc., it has been confirmed that it is a Google problem and that they are working on it. You may have already said that. You may have already seen that.
I did say that to you before when we were in the green room, but yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Okay, so here's one thing that I wanted to do. I wanted to show you another way before we get to the rows. We're gonna put that one in the back burner for just a bit. But I wanted to show you another way that I utilized my Gelli Plate poles. I took a canvas. This is just a standard white canvas. This particular one I think is 11 by 14, but you can use any size, of course. And I wrapped the Gelli Plate poles around it and glued it to it. You can use Mod Podge. You can use what I did, which was matte gel, you know, just a medium, gel medium, acts as a glue. You could use white, Elmer's white glue, the school glue, remember that stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Water it down. Just do probably two parts glue, one part water, and you basically have a homemade Mod Podge. And you can glue this down one piece at a time, tear them up, do a whole sheet. If you do large Gelli Plate poles, you could do the whole thing as a background. And I created what I wanted to see was like a landscape hill with some sky out there. And then you can use this as the background to your other pieces, like the flower that I just cut out, or anything else. So I'm going to show you this again in just a moment. But for the sake of television, we're going to use this white one because I really want the colors to pop. So here's the white canvas. And now, whew, I feel like I have to breathe deeply for this. It's kind of scary.
Do you want a drum roll?
Well, what I want to show you is typically what I would do is cut out my base piece first, and I didn't do that, so it's just a sheet of paper. So if you can just imagine with me, everyone, the sheet of paper isn't there. Just the cutout of the rose underneath is. And then as I reveal the rose to you by removing the pieces, you can kind of see how it's going to go together, and we'll just glue it or tape it, whatever is easiest, into place. Okay? I need my tweezers. Hold on.
Tools of the trade.
You'd think I would have had those handy, but I wasn't thinking that far ahead. Okay, so I'm just going to lift up these cutout pieces, and you'll see the rose kind of being revealed as we do it. And you get the idea, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm going to move them out of the way. Remove some of these pieces. Part of this was to build some excitement, but I think it's also to aggravate the heck out of me, but whatever. Okay, here we go. All right, so now that I've got the pieces cut, I've got the pieces laid out, I know exactly where they're each going to go. Now it's time to glue them on, but for the sake of the show, I'm just going to tape them to this paper. Okay, for the sake of a live crafting show, this is what you got to do sometimes. So let's start with the leaves. Yep, go
you
ahead.
You know what tool I would pull out is that one that has that little sticky stuff on the tip.
Oh, you're genius. Listen to this.
I don't know what you call it. I can't
yeah, the
remember.
the sticky tool, the picker-upper.
Yeah. The picker-upper, yeah.
Okay, so here we go. I'm just going to use my snail tape to do this pretty quickly. Now you'll notice I'm covering up the black lines, right? Am I on camera? Yes, okay.
Yes, you are. Mm-hmm.
I'm covering up the black lines, but I can still kind of see it a little bit. So I can go back over my Sharpie marker with this and really define this if I want to, or I could leave it just as is.
I think it was Sousa. She says she likes the outlining idea.
I do too. And you might find after you've done it that it's not what you want to do. You know, it's just going to depend on how it appears to you as to whether that's the route you want to take or not.
And Tina said, no one ever said leaves have to be green. They can be multicolor like this.
Okay. I'm finding it easier to put this directly on. Here's a tip. Deli paper doesn't like Tombow sticky stuff. Mm. So it's easier to put the tape on the rose itself. And it's kind of like a puzzle piece. And I'm going to do that again. This is where glue would be better, honestly. But for the sake of time, because I really like my viewers and I don't want to torture them anymore. Hopefully you're getting an idea, you're getting inspired to do something. I would love it, if you would take this idea and run with it. And then let us know. As a matter of fact, this I think falls into the category of mixed media. What do you think?
Oh, yeah, you're right. It does.
Definitely does. And then, of course, if you do post it with the hashtag KSDSEPT, and you can go ahead and put that in the comments. I know you will, Debbie.
I will.
If you put that hashtag with your posting of it, be it a photo, a share on Instagram, wherever you're going to put that, then you'll be entered to win our drawing. And you know what happens next? Next week on the show, live here.
A drawing.
Yeah, we give away the prize. So you'll want to be sure to enter before next week's live show so I can search you with that hashtag and find your beautiful works of art. I know somebody posted today. I believe it was Lizzie. I could be wrong. I just saw it really quickly while I was getting ready for the show, so I could be wrong. Somebody correct me out there. Tell me who it was who posted this morning. Yep. This is actually not that bad. This is kind of cool.
Why would you think it was going to be that bad?
Oh, I thought it was going to be tough to be able to put the pieces together.
Mm.
It's not. It's actually quite... especially because I had done like a two-layer on this one, you know, I thought it was going to be tough, and it's not that... So you were going to say something, and I interrupted you because I do that.
Oh, yeah, and because we have a lag in the audio, so that's part of the problem. But your KSDSEPT, you know, that's Kraaft Shaak Drawing September, hashtag, of course, on Instagram, on Facebook, on Google+, on Pinterest?
Pinterest or Twitter? Heck yeah.
Or Twitter? Yeah, any of those places.
Any of those places. I go out and I search, and if you've used the hashtag, that's how I find it. So it's not to torture you, I promise.
Do we know what the prize is yet, or is that a secret?
You know, I have been working on a prize package for the last couple of months, and I was hoping that I would have that prize package ready, and I don't, because the things that I ordered just are not arriving. They keep getting back-ordered. So I will definitely be posting a picture later today or tomorrow that will have the exact prize. You know that it's going to be something crafty, though. Come on. You know you're going to love it, whatever it is.
Yeah. Exactly. We all need that stuff.
It's something you can use in your craft room, I promise. And every once in a while, I actually add things like, you know, some of the Gelli Plate poles that I've made or something like that if you want to use them in your art. So I like to add little bonuses that I don't tell you about. Some of you who have won some of our prizes... I lost the little piece. I don't know if you noticed that, but anyway, I was like, what just happened here? Okay. Back to our regularly scheduled program. Those of you who have, that's what I was trying to say, those of you who have previously won something, tell everyone they need to enter to win because it's going to be awesome, right?
Well,
what do you think?
Woohoo! And now, Sylvia, hopefully Sylvia is relieved. She's just aching over here to see this.
Yeah, I know. It's kind of a buildup, but hopefully it wasn't a letdown. So now again, I could go over this with a black marker. I can go over it with a charcoal pencil and maybe blend it out some so that it has more of a shading value to it rather than the stark line. I can cut this out and then attach it to my canvas, right? So that's that. That is what I wanted to show you guys how different ways you can paper piece. Now imagine that with some of those other drawings that I showed you, like the lily, or some of these are backwards again, the vase with the flowers in it, or this awesome, I don't know what it is, but it's like an artichoke flower or something. That's what I think of every time I look at it. Inspired by one of the posts made in Kraaft Shaak, or I'm sorry, Crafters Community. Imagine doing that detail on this butterfly and how detailed you could get. It would be kind of interesting, don't you think?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's one concept. Another thing you can do, and I'm just going to do this as quickly as I can. It's not going to be completed, of course, but those of you in the After Crafter Party always get the bonus of watching me finish stuff up. So I'm just going to move this stuff out of the way. So what I've taken is a big piece of watercolor paper. It's heavy, 140 pound, and I just cut out a shape. And I happen to choose this kind of Celtic-looking cross. And that's what's going to be my focal point on this particular piece here. And actually, because this one's bigger, but you get the idea of what I'm trying to do. Okay, whoops, let me back it up a little bit so you can see it a little better. So see how that is. Okay, so what we're going to do is turn this cross into a mosaic piece. And we're just going to use some of those pieces that we've already cut out of and tear so we get really broken parts and pieces. And that Liquitex, you can use any kind. Again, make your own Mod Podge, whatever, just something to glue it down. And I've got a brush that I have in the water off camera up here, so this headset, you know what? Those of you who make donations to my website, right now's project is a new audio system, so Heather does not lose her headset every show. So those of you who like projects and want to support projects, that's the one you're supporting now. Thank you very much for your donation. I appreciate you.
Is your cord getting hung up on stuff?
It
does.
Okay, so see this cord, this thing on the cord? That right there is at the exact height of this countertop.
Mm.
And so it catches, and then it yanks it off my head every single show. I've yet to have a show where that doesn't happen. Whatever.
At least your ears are staying on.
Well, this time, I didn't yank any ears off this time. Okay, so the bottom line is you just want to cut up a bunch of pieces or tear them or rip them, and then we're just going to put them on. That's the bottom line. So went from watching me cut to now you're going to watch me glue, rip and glue. The excitement builds here on Kraaft It Live, folks. You just can't stand it. You just can't stand it. And of course, you know, Mom Donna is giving me a call right now. So hi, Mom.
Sorry, hi, Mom.
Can't answer. I'm doing a live show. Maybe you didn't know about that, but that's all right.
So Sylvia wants to know if you could share that picture so she could make one from her jelly pulls. I'm not sure which picture. If she means the
probably
cross?
The rose, maybe. Probably the rose.
Rose. Okay.
Which is fine. I can definitely do that.
She did say rose. Yep. I would love to do that rose.
Okay. I will scan it in, and I will put it. I will put it in the Crafters community. I will also put a link to it in our unified chat after the show is over. I will do all of that. It will be available for anyone who wants.
So, tell me again about the unified chat. This unified chat, this conversation that we're having over here during the live show, is available for a while. Is that correct?
As far as I know, forever and ever.
Ooh.
Isn't that neat? It's kind of a cool concept, isn't it? And
yeah.
it's stored on my website, so you don't have to worry if something, God forbid, if something were to happen to that place we love so much known as Google+, we don't have to ever worry about it going away because it'll be sitting right there on my website waiting for you to chat. And you can actually go in and chat still. So, like, if you go to, oh, let me tell you where to go, right?
Watch it.
Yeah. You want to know where to go. Okay, so it is called Video Treasure Chest on the craftshack.com website. And it's just sitting there waiting for you. Right now we have two shows. After this one's over, we'll have three shows sitting over there. You click the link and you right back into another box just like the one you're in right now, those of you who are watching live. And the chat's there and you can leave a chat. And guess what? I get one of those happy little emails that tells me somebody was in there chatting. It's kind of a nice little surprise throughout my week. All right.
You know what? Andrew put a comment in here, and I could not figure out what he meant until I engaged my brain. He says, gift certificates for the future stores prizes would be nice.
Oh, you know what? That's an excellent idea. I don't want to give away something you can't use just yet, though, so I definitely will be giving gift certificates away once I get the store running. And unfortunately, we've just hit a snag with getting it going this month. Still aiming for the end of October in my head. I like this one with the gold.
Another fun project. Yeah, that's beautiful.
Well, that's kind of we don't ever stop with the projects around here, do we?
No.
So here's what I'm doing. I'm going over, so you're going to kind of lose the shape of the cross, but no worries, because once it's dry, I could just flip it over and cut that off. So hopefully you can see that, what I mean. And I know you keep track of all the time, and you're always watching that stuff. So as we get closer to the end, you be sure to let me know.
I'm giving you the 8-minute countdown right now.
Thank you. That you read my mind, which is not surprising about what I was asking. All right. So hopefully you get the idea of what I'm trying to do here. I don't want, you know, the whole show to be about watching me cut and watching me glue, but that seems to be the way it ended up. And you know what?
We get to listen to you talk, so.
Oh, yeah. That's a great thing. Well, if you really enjoy listening to me talk, you might enjoy also listening to my son talk, which then you should watch Monday Meanderings. I have to admit,
I saw that some of the crafters community members were there during the live show. I saw some comments about that, but I didn't get to watch it yet. So as soon as I get back to the land of fast internet, I will do it.
Yeah, it's kind of weird to think that you might have like a job or a life outside of Craft Shack, but you know, we forgive you. It's okay. All right, let's see. And I don't know if you can tell just how random this is. This is hard for me to be random. I don't do random well. But so far, this is kind of therapeutic. I'm just sort of ripping and placing. There's nothing really. And all these little pieces you can use, too, to cover up like a space right there that needs to be covered. So don't get rid of any of this. You don't want to save all this. Remember that one that I did where we had all those squares? Do you remember that?
Oh, I loved that one. That came together. I had no idea what was going to happen with it. And then when you finished it, it was gorgeous.
I know. It's kind of, well, I don't know if I would say it was gorgeous, but I agree with you that I didn't know where it was going either. That was kind of a fun one. Yeah, we kind of did watercolor quilting. I called that one watercolor quilting with jelly plate poles.
That's right. And I just want to mention here, Sherry mentioned that she probably would not do, she hates fussy cutting, so she probably wouldn't do this. But you know what? No fussy cutting on this one.
No, that's why I wanted to show you, because I feel the same way. You don't always feel like you're in the mood to fussy cut. I know many people who are not fussy cutters at all. And if you don't like doing it, here's another way to do it. Here's another way to use up those jelly plate pulls and still end up with something lovely. Of course, you're not going to see it all because we're running low on time.
You've got 5 minutes, and Nanette asked if that is a Cricut cut.
What is?
The cross, I think.
No, I hand cut it. And you want to know what I used to do this? Maybe you do want to know. I'll show you. I took these really cool, intricate tools known as a ribbon spool and a toilet paper roll.
Or otherwise known as garbage.
Right. But I've learned I don't throw anything away, or else that Sylvia person will have my head. So I don't throw anything away, and now look what I do with all my trash. So I basically put this down. I drew kind of like a this is the middle at the top and the bottom, and this is where I wanted it to go, and then placed this on that line, traced around, then placed one here and here and traced around. It's really uncomplicated as it could be. And voila. So no, you don't need a machine. You don't need special tools at all. You just need your trash.
I'm not sure what Susan R. was mentioning, what she was talking about here. She says, put a piece of masking tape over it, Heather. And I'm not sure what she's referring to there.
I don't know either.
We just get so many cool tips, you know, from the live audience, and so I'm sure that's a cool tip, but I can't remember. I don't know where in the show she was referring.
Well, and perhaps in the next 40 seconds to a minute, she will clarify her conversation for us. Here's what I did. I took one of these deli paper ones that was basically a stencil, and it's very clear. That deli paper, like I said before, is kind of translucent or transparent, and I am placing it down over the top of those other squares. Can you see that? As it dries, because it's very milky right now, but as it dries, it's just going to be that flower shape over the top of the other parts. So it's just adding another layer.
And I think I just realized what Susan R. was talking about. Put a piece of masking tape over that clip on your headset cord.
Yeah, I've tried a bunch of things, and trust me, it doesn't work because I move around too much. So, thank you, though. I appreciate it. I really do. So here's another one. See how this one is? And it's basically the clear. It's going to be clear once it's dry.
Andrew says he's panting in anticipation.
Uh-huh. No pressure. None at all.
He's so dramatic.
He can be. That's why I love him. Okay, I should have ripped this one off more before I did that part, but that's okay. There we go.
Mark Barris is in the room, and he says, wish the video would load for me, but I don't know what he's talking about there. I don't think anyone else is having problems seeing the video.
Oh, that's a bummer. Sometimes that happens. Yeah. Tech is so hard these days. We have all these wonderful capabilities, and yet it still doesn't work 100% for us all the time, which can be frustrating.
And you've got 2 minutes.
Oh, okay. Well, I wanted to show, basically, you know what else you can do? You could actually have painted this first if you wanted to, with like a some color that would peer through, see where all that white is. Imagine if this was colored first, and then the color would be peering through at this point. But I kind of like that intermittent white space. I think that's going to be kind of cool. Let's see. Here's some more kind of see-through-y stuff, but I don't think I'm ready for that just yet. I like this obnoxious yellow. And you know what? I was really kind of frustrated, or not, no, that's the wrong word. I was afraid, and afraid is a little too dramatic, but I was concerned that I wouldn't want to tear these up, like it was going to be difficult to do, and so far, I've had no problems. Of course, I can't figure out what I'm trying to say, but that's not new, is it?
So Michael has a suggestion on the headset.
All right, I'm listening.
Wireless.
Yeah, I know. And again, If you would like to make a donation to the Kraaft Shaak, the donation button is listed on our homepage. Or you can just go straight below the video here, and you should see it down below. Just kidding, folks. Just kidding.
Another suggestion from Andrew regarding time.
Uh-huh.
Use bigger pieces of paper.
Well, okay. Smart. Mm-hmm. You know, I would use bigger pieces of paper, but how good would that look? I don't know.
Ick. Okay, yeah. And speaking of time, you are out of it.
All right, folks. Well, thank you very much for joining us. This has been Heather cuts paper and then glues it. And I want to thank you for joining us for that fascinating extravaganza of art. Actually, honestly, how to use up your Gelli Plate poles, I think this is by far my favorite way to do it. So hopefully you've enjoyed it. If you are going to join us in the After Crafter Party, just leave a message and we'll be letting you know. Open up that chat box, by the way, just in case there's an issue. And I'm going to say stop broadcast. What do you think? Want to say goodbye, Debbie?
Goodbye, Debbie. Oh, no, that's not what I'm trying. But sorry, you guys. Lame. It was great to talk to you all. See you soon.
Bye-bye.